it seems like our girls.
Done. Yeah, that's how fast it's gonna be. Okay.
Come and support your boys today at.
I forgot what you said. What did
you do? Prom is coming out quickly, and if you don't have a date. This you
now. That's I hate that. That's so awkward. No, you have to. Okay.
I mean, yeah.
Hello. Okay. With this
Pasadena Memorial Mavericks against the bleh. Our
Switch is really, really, but really.
Today we're gonna talk about something very scary today. No, I don't need to put the today part. Which means neither one of them has secured the Republican nominee. Thank you!
Oh, against Manville. Okay. Yeah, less loose.
Don't forget to vote for your Twitter at what? Don't forget to vote for your favorite.
Good morning, Longhorns. I'm Andres Tamez, and welcome to JFD TV for Friday, April the 7th. For the top story this week, Tuan Nguyen checked up on theater's recent success at UIL.
Our theater department went into UIL and had a successful competition. What did the UIL accomplish?
We have accomplished so much this year. We took first place at district and by district. We advanced again at area. We are now top 24 schools in the state. That's a top 8%. We've won numerous acting awards, including Best Actress, technical awards, including Best Male Technician. We're really proud of all the accomplishments the kids have made.
How long have the cast been practicing?
We began working as soon as we came back from Christmas break, and we've been working diligently every day. The cast has worked so incredibly hard, and their hard work is paying off.
As a director, has this production lived up to your expectations?
It has far exceeded my expectations. There are four directors on this production, and we have all worked so very hard with the students, the cast, and crew.
When is your next performance?
Our next performance is Saturday at San Jac College Central. The competition itself starts at 12:30 and plays go back to back.
Make sure to congratulate the UIL cast members. Reporting for JAT TV, I'm Tuan Nguyen.
It's that time of the year for our Lariat's annual spring show.
Spring show is a very awaited show at the end of the year that our Lariat's have been working very hard for and can't wait for you to watch. Make sure to come out and watch the show tonight and tomorrow night at 7 p.m. in the auditorium. You can buy your ticket at the door for $10. Reporting for JFD TV, I'm Ciclali Feria.
And now, here's a look at sports.
I'm Sochi Navarro, and your Longhorn Sports Report starts now. All my friends say stop wasting your days on a runaway. Never mind the time it took. Our soccer team has been busy, winning two playoff games since our last show. Here's reporter Hugo Martinez with all the action.
Our
varsity boys were prepared for a fight and showed it Friday night as they finished the game with a result of 4-1 against Brazos Wood, advancing on to the next round. Goals of the night were made by Edwin Saldivar, Israel Perez, and Kevin Hernandez. What did you say to the team before the game to motivate them?
Well, besides the usual, the game plan, everything, the captain stepped up and told us that sometimes things are meant to be, and we believe that it was meant to be, so that's what happened.
What techniques did you put to use to score tonight?
We just gave it our all. We left our heart on the field, and it showed in the scoreboard.
Name some things that helped you tonight to win.
Having Dobie out here, having Mr. Moses, having the support of our fans, our families, our friends, our teachers, that's what carried us the extra mile. We appreciate it. It's a blessing to work at Dobie, and it's a blessing for our students to go to such a great school.
Although they faced great competition, our soccer team managed to strongly defend themselves against the North Shore Mustangs, ending with a score of 2-0 and moving on to semifinals. Some of the night's highlights were Edwin Saldivar scoring a penalty goal and Kevin Hernandez scoring another goal. How does it feel to finally advance to the fourth round after all this hard work?
It's a sweet feeling knowing that after all the work we put in preseason and every game that we're finally here. The hard part was getting here, and now we just have to finish the job.
As team captain, how did you lead the team to victory Tuesday night?
As a captain, you just want the best for your team, and with this game we just had to believe to get through, and that's what's going to make us go all the way, believing.
Our full Dobie pride must be shown tonight. Go support our varsity soccer team as they play a historic semifinals game against Katy Seven Lakes tonight at Deer Park at 7:30. Reporting for JFD-TV, I'm Hugo Martinez.
Our Lady Longhorn showed what Dobie is made of as they went up against South Houston. Reporter Samantha Robles has the details.
Our softball girls came home with the victory, scoring the game 17-1. What did your last game teach you?
That we stay focused throughout the entire game and execute in a timely manner.
What do you overall think you could have done better?
As a team, I think we could have executed better, and teams such as Soho, that we should beat them in 3 innings and not 5.
What is your motivation for tonight's game?
My motivation for tonight's game is that it's senior night, and it's a reminder that we only have a few games left and to start taking advantage of it.
Make sure you come out and support our girls against Rayburn at the PISD complex at 6:30. Reporting for JFD-TV, I'm Samantha Robles.
Baseball had a tough game Tuesday afternoon. Here's Valerie Cantu with a closer look.
Every day I spend my time feeling fine, waiting here to find the sign that I can understand.
Feeling fine, waiting here to find the sign that I should take it slow. Here I go.
Off again, there he go, to another dimension, my mind.
The boys worked hard, but sadly took a tough loss with a score of 12-0. What do you plan on doing to help the team improve?
We got to make sure that we stay positive. It was a bad defeat that we had, but it was just one game. We still got 7 more games to go, and the guys need to understand that it was just one game. We got to take it one game at a time, stay positive.
Ask Coach, what did you learn from yesterday's game?
Our pitching has to get better. The boys were throwing strikes, but the thing is they were throwing the strikes down, right down the middle of the plate. We're going to work on that by throwing live BP sessions where we actually have a batter up there. That way it focuses more on the pitchers to make sure that they're hitting their spots, hitting corners like they're supposed to.
Make sure to come out and support our Longhorns tonight as they go against Beaumont Westbrook here at Dobie. Reporting for JFDTV, I'm Valerie Cantu.
Track had a big meet on Friday. Here's reporter Alondra Rios with more.
How do you maintain your speed?
Well, when I'm running, I usually look at the person beside me or in front of me.
What's your biggest challenge during the race?
It's usually my blocks and my start, because my finish is really strong, but just getting out as fast as possible gets really hard at times.
Learning how to pace myself throughout the two laps and finishing strong.
How do you maintain to stay focused throughout your eight laps?
I try to stay positive, and I mean, I just run.
Make sure to wish the girls good luck on their district meet. Reporting for JFDTV, I'm Alondra Rios.
Now back to Andres in the studio.
Thanks, Sochi. With Easter around the corner, our reporters Sochi Navarro and Jasmine Taparis made you a quick treat.
Those were the times I can't rewind, when we were young and you were mine. I'll pass it off as long as I can.
For this treat, you're going to need some Peeps, chocolate bunnies, chocolate eggs, flower lollipops, some Easter grass, and your choice of a plastic baggie. You're going to start off by placing some Easter grass in your plastic baggie. You're then going to place the Peeps on top of the Easter grass along with some chocolate eggs and the chocolate bunny. You're then going to tie it off with the flower lollipop sticking outside of the plastic baggie, and there you have some treats you can give out to some of your friends.
First, you're going to need marshmallow, Rice Krispies cereal, butter, and your choice of frosting. Next, you're going to place 1.5 tablespoons of butter in a saucepan. Then pour 5 ounces of marshmallows into the pan. Stir until completely melted. Next, pour 3 cups of Rice Krispies cereal into a bowl. After, pour your marshmallow mix into the bowl and stir until well coated. Place your Rice Krispies mix into a pan and begin molding into an egg. Finally, take your frosting and begin decorating your Rice Krispies egg. Reporting for JFDTV, I'm Sochi Navarro.
And I'm Jasmine Tavares.
That'll do it for JFDTV. Make sure to follow us on YouTube and Vimeo, and don't forget to follow us on Twitter at JFD_TV. Have a great day. We'll see you next week. Good morning, Longhorns. Good morning, Longhorns. I'm Andres Tamez, and welcome to JFDTV for April the 7th.
April! Our boys' soccer team has been busy winning 2 playoff games. No, I messed up. Okay. Oh, my hair looks gross. Okay.
Don't put that on a blooper, please.
Our Lady Longhorn showed what Dobie is made of. Our boys' soccer team has been busy winning 2 playoff games since our last show. Here's who. Track had a big meet. okay.
Man. This is a lot tougher than it looks, man.
Conquistador of Mexico, the Zulu and the Navajo, the Belgians in the Congo, short memory. Plantation in Virginia, the Raj in British India, the deadline in South Africa, short memory, the star. story of El Salvador, the silence of Hiroshima, destruction of Cambodia, short memory. Hilton style with running water specially bought, short memory. A smallish man, Afghanistan, a watchdog in a nervous land. They're only there to lend a hand, short memory. The friendly five, a dusty smile, wake up in sweat at dead of night. Tense new rises, hey, shot memory.